you have completed a fresh new installation of Windows 11 or Windows Server 2025, but your environment does not have internet. Fortunately, you can use DISM or the Add-WindowsPackage cmdlet to apply offline standalone Windows updates. We'll also install the latest Microsoft Defender Antivirus definition and Edge updates. From a computer with internet access, navigate to the Windows Release Health page. Click on the Release Information link for your operating system. Scroll down to the Release History section. Click the Knowledge Base article for the latest update. Highlight and copy the Knowledge Base number. Open the Microsoft Update Catalog, paste the Knowledge Base number, and click Search. Find the applicable updates and click the Download button. Download the updates. In addition to the latest OS update, download the latest .NET Framework updates. In the Microsoft Update Catalog search bar, search for this string as typed. We use this term because the Update Catalog search feature is absolute trash. Sort the list, the last updated, in descending order so that the latest date is at the top. Find the applicable .NET Framework update, click the Download button, and download the update. Navigate to the Microsoft Edge for Business webpage. Download the latest version for your platform. Navigate to the Microsoft Security Intelligence website. Scroll to the Manually Download the Update section and take note of the version number and release date. Download the Security Intelligence definition file that matches your Windows operating system. The file name will always be the same. As a best practice, we should verify the integrity of our downloaded updates. In File Explorer, open the folder where you downloaded the files. Right-click in an empty area and select Open in Terminal. Use the get-filehash cmdlet to get the SHA-1 hash of the updated files. Notice the hashes match the latter part of the file name. Unfortunately, we don't have a SHA-1 or a SHA-256 hash to which we can verify the Defender's definition file's integrity. The best we can do using the get-itemProperty cmdlet is to check the downloaded file version number. And for the Edge browser update.msi file, we just hope for the best since we don't have anything to verify against. At the target computer, open Windows Explorer and create a folder path that will contain the updated files. Transfer the updates to the offline system or network and place them into the folder you created. We can install the updates silently using the Windows Update Standalone Installer, WUSA, which leverages the Windows Update infrastructure to perform the required actions according to the update's contents. Open an administrative terminal or PowerShell session. We'll automate and ease the process by creating a function that will display the current OS version, build number, and pre-installed hotfixes. Declare a variable for the shutdown notice, the update folder, and for each update's full file name and path. Install the Windows Defender definition update. Install the Edge browser update. Install the updates using WUSA by looping through the full paths to the MSU update files. And restart the computer when everything is done. To run, call the function. Note the current Windows version and build number. When using the /quiet and the /restart options, the Windows Update Standalone Installer provides no visual feedback. This update will take a while. Please be patient. After the reboot, log in, open the terminal, and type this command. You will see the OS has been updated to the latest build and the current knowledge base hotfix has been applied. Right-click Start and select System. In the Windows Specifications section, the OS build number should also reflect the latest applied. Click on Apps, Install Apps. Type Edge to filter. The version number and install date should reflect updated values. Click on Privacy and Security, Windows Security. Select Virus and Threat Protection, and under Virus and Threat Protection Updates, click Protection Updates. The Security Intelligence version and the date created should match that of the downloaded update. Alternatively, we can use DISM or the Add-WindowsPackage cmdlet to install offline updates. Open an administrative terminal or PowerShell session. Again, to automate and ease the process, I'm creating a function that will install the Windows updates using DISM with the no restart option. Likewise, we can use the Add-WindowsPackage cmdlet. When using DISM or the Add-WindowsPackage cmdlet and specifying a folder for the package path option, there is no need to loop through the packages. To run, call the function. After the reboot, log in, open an administrative terminal or PowerShell session, and type this command. If your OS build did not change, hit the up arrow key to redefine the function and run the function again. When using DISM or the Add-WindowsPackage cmdlet, you may have to run the update twice when the OS is freshly installed from OE Media. DISM and the Add-WindowsPackage will recognize the updates that have already been applied and continue to install those that have yet to be installed. Again, after the reboot, log in, open a terminal, and type this command. Now, you should see that the OS has been updated to the latest build and that the current knowledge base hotfix has been applied. I hope you enjoyed this video, learned something new, and found it useful. If you have any feedback, corrections, or suggestions, please let me know in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and pass it on to others. And I thank you for watching.